Either one would warrant a celebration, but together they command our attention in a way that is distinctively Lawrenceville. The Father's Building has always been about our parents and alumni and their impact on the school. The Lawrenceville Medal is the highest honor we bestow on a member of the alumni body, a recognition of that individual's impact on our larger societies. I want to thank the Alumni Association for their role in tonight's observance. In my convocation address earlier this fall, I spoke to the students about the sense of place that characterizes Lawrenceville. I walked them through the history of the campus and the additions of the circle, the crescent, and the bowl. I told them the story of the Father's Building and its special relationship to the Harkness system as one of the two classroom buildings to get Harkness tables when they arrived in 1936. But it's also the case that Lawrenceville's campus can't be separated from the people who inhabit it, the students who live and learn here, the faculty who teach and raise their families on our 700-acre campus. Nor can it be separated from the alumni and parents who have supported its growth. Today, we honor multiple legacies. One, the legacy of the Fathers Association, and specifically the Fuller family, whose generosity, both then and now, is reflected in the building you see today. Another, the legacy of Aldo Leopold, class of 1905, in whose name we present tonight's award to sports writing legend Bob Ryan from the class of 1964. And once more, the legacy of Harkness teaching and learning that has become synonymous with the Lawrenceville education. Two new aspects of our long Harkness legacy are being introduced with the renovation of Pop Hall, in keeping with the intentions of Sue and Mort Fuller from the class of 1960. Lead donors to the project, and also thanks to the support of Jeremy Mario, class of 1988, and the Mario family. The new, beautifully landscaped courtyard linking Pop to its neighbor, Woods Memorial Hall, is a gift from the Mario family, and the patio at its center is in the shape of a Harkness table. And if you look inside the foreign language classrooms in this building, you will see a modular version of our own traditional Harkness tables, lending them the versatility requested by our language teachers. Mort and Sue Fuller stepped forward early in the bicentennial campaign with their commitment to the Pop Hall renovation. The Fuller family has deep roots at Lawrenceville, and their involvement is closely intertwined with the history of the Father's Building and of the school. Mort's grandfather, class of 1896, was among the fathers who sponsored the original construction, and his father, class of 1928, was among its first occupants. Mort's graduation in 1960 coincided with our 150th anniversary. His oldest daughter, Liza, who is here today, was among the first girls to enroll at Lawrenceville when we went co-ed. And his stepdaughter was the first member of the Fuller family to attend Lawrenceville in the 21st century, graduating in 2001, 105 years after Mort Fuller Sr. A possible future Laurentian, Willow Summer, Mort's granddaughter, has also joined us this evening. Just as with the original construction, the renovation of Pop Hall was a group effort, and I'd like to recognize the additional donors, parents and alumni who so generously joined the Fuller and Mario families in supporting this endeavor. Bob Howard and family. Bob is the parent of two Laurentians and a grandparent of two more. Clara and Joe Tsai from the class of 1982. Gail and Dick Barrett from the class of 1967. Myeongjin and Geunho Lee, Lawrenceville parents. Amanda and John Waldron, class of 1987, and the Getz family, Sandy and Bert Getz, class of 1955, and honorary 1956, and Susie and Bert Jr. from the class of 1985. More than 1,600 students will be taking classes in Pop Hall this year. Over 32 teachers will teach in it, and over 167 courses will be offered. The Father's Building, plays a key role in shaping the educational experience of our community. We are enormously grateful to the alumni and parents who over many generations have made our campus an environment that supports the highest levels of teaching and learning. We are especially grateful today to the Fuller and Mario families and others who have made the dream of renovating and modernizing this building a reality. Please join me in thanking and saluting them. I'd now like to turn this podium over to Tom Carter from the class of 1970, who is president of the Board of Trustees. Tom?
Thanks, Liz, and welcome to all of you wonderful people coming here on this event. I really, once again, want to reiterate our thanks to the donors. Without them, this would not have happened. And boy, and girls, isn't this just great? When I came in here yesterday, I was just, I thought this was knocked out. How beautiful is this? And this has always been one of my favorite buildings. It was getting a little long in the tooth, but it's certainly wonderful right now. And it's always stood as, to me, as one of the bookends of iconic structures at Lawrenceville, coming in from the other side, seeing the Mem Hall, and then coming in from this side, always seeing Pop Hall. And it's just a wonderful thing to see this building put back into the shape that it deserves to be in. There's a lot of history in this building. It was built in 1925. I don't think any of you were here then. And it was built for $200,000 by the newly founded Fathers Association, which included Bill Delano, who was an architect, and also a class of 1891. And it also included Mort B. Fuller of 1896, a father of three Laurentians and grandfather of Mort, which the more things change, the more they stay the same. But there is a lot of difference, as we all know. We can't do this for $200,000 anymore. although this renovation is definitely inspirational for some of the other projects we have on hand, so look around and see how wonderful this is. Some other things that have changed over time are not only cost, and despite the hubbub around the naming of the Washington, D.C. football team, I might bring to mind, some of you may remember that in the basement of this building, we used to have a barber shop. And that's where the young men got their hair cut. And at least in my tenure, the barber was affectionately referred to as Injun Joe, which was a reflection on the type of haircut you would get when you went there. And you had to pay extra for it. Anyway, what a wonderful thing that the Fathers Association did in 1925, and now it's referred to as Pop Hall, which is a wonderful acronym or nickname for the building. And it tying the Fathers Association and the Fullers and all the rest of the donors together, and all of you, and the name of this building really underscores the importance of the alumni and the parents of the Laurentians and all they have done for the school, and how important they are for the school and will be in the future. And I just want to thank you all for being here. Thank you.
Next, we'd like to hear from the person responsible for this renovation, Mort Fuller.
First, let me make a correction. One of the people, because I'd like to, first of all, acknowledge my family today, and first my wife Sue and partner on this project. My daughters Liza and Katie. And also John Bailey, my roommate at Lawrenceville. I didn't have a lot. And Rick Wright, my roommate at Princeton. So it's wonderful to have everybody here tonight. You know, let me ask you a question. How many of you are familiar with the old basement in Pop Hall? What do you think? You know, when Liz asked us to make a contribution to the bicentennial campaign, and Pop Hall was on the list, it became a logical fit. Because my grandfather was one of the original fathers who built the building in 1925. When we started out, we were thinking of it as a simple renovation. But when BCJ made their proposal, and we saw what they could do, particularly with the now the ground floor, no longer the basement, and also with bringing light into the building, we realized that we had an opportunity to participate in a transformational project. It became an opportunity to, rather than, more than just doing something for the school, doing something to us that would be really special. And with the support of Liz and the board, it was a collaborative effort. It was led by Wes Brooks, the school's chief executive and operating officer, and it was backed up strongly by the Building and Grounds team of Gary Skirzynski, Kevin Lysick, and James Keyshawn. As Sue and I were also on the team, we started out and got so intrigued that we came to almost every meeting. We're also fortunate to have had Bohlin, Cywinski, Jackson, BCJ, chosen as the architect. And tonight we have Randy Reed, principal with the firm, who was involved in the project, and also Wolf Arendt, Lawrenceville class of 89, who guided the project every inch of the way. And also the contractor, BJ Scozzari, who has done a lot of quality work for Lawrenceville. And there are five Skozzaris who are Lawrenceville alumni. Also the donors who participated with us on the project. The Mario family in particular for the courtyard that joins Pop and Mem all together in a very special way. And each of those named on the plaque that's inside the front door. So Sue and I could not be happier with the results. I think, you know, we just stand here and look at the light and with the glass doors and being able to keep the wooden doors open during the day. It really has been a very special and wonderful opportunity for us. So thank you very much.
I'm honored to be here on behalf of my family and our foundation, which helped support this project. My brother, Greg, is here somewhere as well. His son, Griffin, who's class of 14, and my daughter, Gretchen, class of 16. You are still graduating, right, Greg? Just making sure, still class of 14. I haven't heard anything, just making sure. You know, Lawrenceville has produced a lot of greatness, a lot of exceptional people. And you get a chance to see some of that tonight in the Aldo Leopold Award, Bob Ryan being the latest of that list. But you look down that list and it's incredible, the people that have come through here and what they've gone on to do. We've all had a part in that, and we're very honored to have contributed a bit to that. And you have to step back and think, what is it that makes this place special and that allows us to produce so many people like that? And there are two real philosophies, two pillars, at least for the last 80 or so years, that have led that. and that's the house system and the Harkness method of teaching. And you know, traditions come and go sometimes. Some of them need to be nurtured and supported. Sometimes you need to move on from them. Other times you just need to modify them. But it's important to hold on to those principles and those key elements. The house system is embodied in the bones of this campus. When you see the circle, and later when we build the crescent. You know, we hoped, as a family, to help bring the Harkness at least to the skin of the campus there with that the design of the courtyard, because we hope that Harkness is always a part of what we do here. We think it makes a tremendous difference in the teachings here. There are always challenges at schools like this, and I've had the great honor of serving on the board for a number of years now, and we constantly are looking at that next hill to climb. This was one of the great challenges, and you know, you can look across campus and you see where there have been leaders that have helped tackle those challenges. The Kirby family, the Bunn family, the Carter family, the Albert-Sheen family, Woods and Green families, and now the Fuller family and what they've done for us. When they lead us up a hill off a charge like this, they have to bring a team together, and we're very happy to be part of that team. But it's appropriate to step back and recognize those leaders and what they help us do and keep certain traditions. You don't have to raise everything and build it back. Sometimes you can refurbish it. So just, again, Mark and Sue, downstairs, by the way. Wolf knows that. Where's Wolf? He knows that. I mean, just unbelievable. And we're so pleased to have been a part of it. Part of what we did in this project, the family petitioned Glaxo Pharmaceuticals to donate to the school a portrait that had been painted of my father when he had been the chairman of that company and that the company owned. The portrait was done by renowned artist Everett Kinsler, who's painted seven presidents, two official portraits, Presidents Ford and Reagan, that are hanging in the White House, 1,200 portraits overall. And also, most notably for this crowd, he painted the portrait of Headmaster McClellan that hangs in the Foundation House. Early in his career, he painted my father's portrait in the middle of his career. He is near the end of his career, but is still painting. And we worked with the school, and I'm happy to announce tonight that the Foundation voted last week to support having Everett Kinsler paint a portrait of Ward Fuller that will hang in the faculty lounge upstairs. It is important to recognize leaders like this because we always have another set of hills to climb, and we're going to over the horizon. We need to continue to have leaders who step up and continue to make this school a great place that produces people like Bob Knight and the other Apple League World Award winners. So we're very pleased to be part of this. Thank you.
So last but certainly not least, no building is official without a blessing. So I'd like to invite our school chaplain, Sue and Stephanie Moore, up to give a blessing for the building.
In the last couple of days, I've asked a whole lot of people, hey, what do you love about the new old Pop Hall? The blessing is a compilation of many of their replies. It is also a call and response sort of blessing. I'm going to read a few lines, then I'm going to look up, and you are going to respond in three parts. It's going to go like this, and the light, and the light. Now we're going to repeat that. Looking up.
And the light.
Now please join me in a spirit of great thanksgiving. Hey, what do you love about the new old Pop Hall? I know it's selfish, but I love my space. The speakers, the textiles, the whole smart board, whiteboard thing, the benches, the rich mahogany, the cold that keeps us awake.
And the lights, hey, what do you love about the new old Pop Hall? The bookcases, the smell. Three of my classes are here. The glass doors, the new tables, the brick, the wood floor, the Zen stools, everything. I look out on Woods Mem and the chapel. I look out on iconic Lawrenceville.
And the lights.
And the lights.
And the lights.
Hey, what do you love about the new old Pop Hall? Seeing students walk through the halls, the paintings. Oh, they're photos? Whoa, that's cool. Hearing students walk through the halls. My classroom with three windows makes us so happy. The shining, the tope, it's a tradition that you are in at Rev.
And the light.
And the light.
And the light.
One more. Hey, what do you love about the new old Pop Hall? The sound of the voices, the echo of voices, the rotunda, the courtyard, the openness, the warmth. That it could be 1920, that it could be 2020. The convergence that's already begun. Being back in Pop Hall is like coming home.
Light.
Light.
May the shimmering light of this restoration nourish and illuminate the light within.